Hi, I'm Maggie, a graduate student here at the Iowa Center for Assistive Technology Education and Research, also known as iCater. Today I'm going to present a demo of Snap and Read Universal, a Chrome extension. Snap and Read Universal has a ton of cool features for students who are struggling to read, students who are learning English as a second language, and students with reading disabilities. Once a student has added Snap and Read Universal to their Chrome account, they will see a crosshair on their Chrome toolbar. Before getting started with the tool, students can adjust their settings by right-clicking and selecting Options. In Options, students have the ability to change the text color, the highlighting color, the speaker, the volume of the speech, the rate of speed of the speaker, the pitch, and if they're using the translation component, they can change to over 100 languages, different languages. So say you have a student who's interested in researching the planet Neptune, and they find a cool website that they like to have read to them. What they could do is utilize the text-to-speech feature, which is this here. What they could do is click on the feature and then select the text in which they would like to be read.
The ice giant Neptune was the first planet located through mathematical predictions rather than through regular observations of the sky.
Galileo. As you can see, that not only the student has access to the text-to-speech, but they're also receiving the visual cues of the highlighting. That allows the students to maintain concentration on what's being read. So let's say a student has a worksheet that they would like read to them. They can use the text-to-speech feature for that as well. What they would do is click on the text-to-speech icon and then select the text that they would like read.
Wolves in Yellowstone National Park. Wolves are large, wild dogs. They can be black, brown, white, or gray, with variations of color in their fur. They usually have a white or light-colored muzzle and legs, with the dark end of their tail. They are 41 to 63 inches long, 32 to 34 inches high.
So there you can see that the support of the highlighting and the text-to-speech assists the student in comprehension. And it works well, not only with text, but numerals as well. So say a student has a document or a website that is inaccessible and they cannot utilize the text-to-speech icon. In that case, when I try to use the text-to-speech icon and click on the document, you can see that nothing's happening there. That's because this document is saved as an image. In those cases, what you'd want to do is select the crosshair icon, which is this. Then select either the entire page or document or a selection. You allow the icon to
the
process.
English language is divided into three periods. Old English, OE, also called Anglo-Saxon, from the 4003 to 1066. Middle English, ME, from 1066 to about the 14003, and modern.
So again, you have a text that's saved as an image, and the student still has access to text-to-speech, but utilizing the crosshair this time. So let's say you have a student who has difficulty with vocabulary. That's where we can use this feature, the icon. It's called the text leveling feature. What a student would do, they would select the text leveling. It'll turn blue. And then select the text that they would like leveled. Okay, there we go. So you can see here that with text leveling, the text or the words, the vocabulary words that are in, or the text or the statement that are in parentheses have been leveled. So when I select, put my cursor over a statement or a text, you can see that galaxy was the initial word, and it changed galaxy to large star system or large group of things. So again, another example. Oh, that's galaxy again. Let's do another one. Territory. So it changed the word territory to land area owned or controlled by someone. So if a student has difficulty reading or difficulty with vocabulary, they can use the text leveling. So once they have leveled the text, they can go back, use the text-to-speech icon, select the text they would like read.
To paint a three-dimensional picture of the whole large star system, large group of things. Our large star system, large group of things, is a structure measuring 100,000 light years across.
They can still have access to that text-to-speech coupled with the text leveling. So say you have a student who has difficulty with learning English because it's their second language. In those instances, the student has the capability of translating text. So what the student would do, select the text they would like translated, select the translation icon, and I've selected French, so you can see the passage has turned into French. And then when I click on it, it turns back to English. And then you click on it again, and it goes back to French. Now, a student can have text-to-speech in a different language. In my settings option, I have the language set as to French, and then I have selected the speaker. So we'll go back, and we'll hear it read in French. So we'll select on the text-to-speech. Select where you want to start reading.
Près d'un million de milles de la Terre est le plus grand petit cartographe qui ait jamais existé. Il est situé à un point gravitationnellement stable dans l'espace sur le côté opposé de notre planète à partir du Soleil. Il vaut mieux être grand parce que...
So if that speed, once you turn the, change the translation, if the speed of the translated language is too fast, again, the student can go into the icon, snap and read icon, and select options and change the rate of speed. Okay, and so the last feature I'm going to show you is the note-taking feature. Cut that back on. And before a student can use the note-taking feature, they'll have to set up an outline. They can do that by utilizing this arrow. So what they would do is go in, create a name for their new outline. And then you'll see that the note-taking icon is now highlighted. It's no longer grayed out. I'm going to change this back to English and cut the translation off. And so what I would do is highlight the text here, select the note-taking option, and you will see that what I selected is presented here in the outline now. So in addition to the content in the outline, you also have a reference if the student needs to go back to that page. Say they wanted to add something about Neptune, they could go to that web page, select what they wanted to enter, select note-taking icon, and there it is, as well as the source. Now, some students may be required to create a works cited or a reference page. Snap and Read Universal also provides that capability, whether the student needs to format their citations in APA, MLA, or Chicago style. If, for instance, Snap and Read doesn't pick up the citation, the student has the capability to manually input citations. And Snap and Read provides a template on how to insert citations for journal articles, movies, newspapers, television, and art. Well, thanks for joining me for this short demo. I hope you enjoyed the features, and thanks for watching.